And it was Knight's Hamish Blake, who did steal the show last night, taking home the coveted gold. He is en route this morning, we understand, with our very own Brooke Boney, who's lucky to be alive. This is a live shot from his rickshaw.
How are they getting here?
Yeah, they're on a little rickshaw.
Like one of those green taxis, I think, isn't it?
Yeah, no, it's a rickshaw. I don't know how many times I need to say it.
Rickshaw. But I'd like to see it.
Why aren't you listening, Ali?
I would love a burger, thank you.
Is it a rickshaw? Oh,
it'd be great if you don't
I understand.
All right, they're going to be joining us very, very shortly, but let's go now to Mia Glover, who is at the Star. Mia, some sore heads this morning.
Yeah, so many sore heads this morning, Ali, but what a party it was, wasn't it? We've come to 19. This is where the post-Logie's recovery brunch will be. So a lot of celebrities will be here later this morning. And I think the accessory of the morning will be sunglasses, won't it? A lot of sore heads. But it was an absolutely spectacular night, and what a way to welcome back the Logie's to the Goldie.
It had all the glitz and glamour. Australian television's biggest party, back after a two-year hiatus. From the bold to the beautiful, the dress code, nothing short of fabulous. Kicking off the night, the hilarious Julia Morris.
I mean, what sort of night do we have ahead of us when they let a loose unit like me open the show?
Then it was on with the show. Nine's Lego Masters and Travel Guides both picking up gongs, while Barnsley, Jessica Mowboy and UK superstar Callum Scott... Sporting icon Bruce McAvaney was inducted into the Logie's Hall of Fame.
I wondered how I'd feel tonight when I walked up here. I feel a lot of love, actually, and a lot of warmth, so thank you very much. I really do.
But the real highlight, a heartfelt tribute to the king of the Logies, Bert Newton.
It's still very raw, and I'll never get over him not being here. But I know that he's with me and he's inside me.
The most popular presenter accolade, now named in his honour, awarded to Hamish Blake. And it wasn't his only win.
And the winner of the Gold Logie for 2022 is... Hamish Blake!
Yeah, Hamish is coming up very, very soon. But, guys, this is my new friend, Amber, and she's got the perfect recovery this morning. The hair of the dog. So here we go. Come up here and have one of these, hey?
Send a couple hours.
Is that a Virgin Bloody Mary? Or
of course it is. It's morning TV. Yeah, what else would it be at this hour?
Alcohol to straighten yourself out.
You've got enough in your system already there, pal.
That's it. And Hamish is, on, by the way, still en route. He's in one of these green rickshaws that they're synonymous with on the go. They don't even know they're live at the moment. But that wouldn't be... Brooke would not be feeling very well, right? Look at her. She looks like the Queen. I hope she's not
swearing.
She
was still going hard on the dance floor when I last saw her. So, anyway... I'm going to give that girl a good talking to when she arrives.
Yes.
It won't be far away now.
Okay, sweet.
Well, let's move on. And athletes internationally are this morning reacting to news that transgender people will be banned from women's competitive swimming. Let's go live to Nine's Europe correspondent, Carrie-Anne Greenbank. Carrie, this follows a decision by the sport's governing body.
Good morning, Ali. Well, it does, and it's a really historic decision. FINA has essentially put it to a vote, and of its 152 members, 71% agreed with its new policy, which essentially bans transgender athletes from competing in women's elite races unless they transitioned before the age of 12. So essentially, if the athletes have gone through any measure of male puberty, they can't compete. Now, FINA is saying that it is working towards creating an open category for transgender athletes, which would be a first of its kind. It's saying that it is trying to find that balance between being inclusive but also being fair in competition. Australian swim star Kate Campbell was one of the first to comment on this new policy.
It is my hope that young girls all around the world can continue to dream of becoming Olympic and world champions in a female category, prioritising the competitive cornerstone of fairness.
There has been a lot of reaction to this news since, some people calling it fair and common sense, one advocacy group at least calling it discrimination, and that reaction is continuing now, Ali.
OK, good stuff. Thanks, Curry.
Collingwood AFL star Jordan De Goey is expected to front the club this morning after a wild Bali getaway. Christina Hearn joins us from the club's HQ in Melbourne. Chris, good morning. He arrived back home last night.
Alex, passengers report seeing De Goey on their flight on a plane that touched down around about midnight in Tullamarine. No sign of him in arrivals. He could have been let out a side door. But there is no escaping Collingwood officials. He's expected to face the music today after social media images emerged of his boozy Bali break. And that included images of him making a lewd gesture and also attempting to expose a woman's breast. De Goey released a statement, not apologising, instead attacking the media for relentless pursuit and persecution of athletes, he said, will end in tragedy if no one speaks up. Of course, this is not the first time the 26-year-old Collingwood star has been in hot water. Last October, he was involved in a New York nightclub fight. Alex.
It's not good. All right, thanks, Chris.
The government is aiming to fast-track its purchase of nuclear-powered submarines as experts warn we're living in an increasingly risky strategic environment. Live federal politics reporter Fiona Willen in Canberra. Fee, good morning to you again. The Defence Minister is hoping to have the subs delivered as soon as possible now.
Well, Carl, there's concern over how long it's going to take to get these nuclear-powered submarines. They're not expected to be in the water until the 2040s. But Australia's conventional submarines are ageing and they'll be retired before then. So the government is aiming to fast-track the process as much as possible. Now, it'll either be getting the submarines from the US or the UK. It hasn't decided which way to go yet. But the Defence Minister, Richard Marles, has indicated to News Corp the time frame for delivery will be a factor in the decision. Security experts say, in the meantime, things are becoming increasingly vulnerable in the region.
We are seeing a much more adverse strategic environment out there with the rise of China in particular, and it's going to get worse in coming years.
Some experts also say production delays are the reason for the wait, and this isn't something that can necessarily be accelerated. Carl?
Fee, thank you.
As the country faces a housing and cost of living crisis, the Queensland government is unveiling a new plan to boost supply. Up to 1,200 social and affordable houses will be built under a new commercial partnership worth $1 billion. Almost 600 new homes will be created in the first stage, which will kick off next year. And get ready, Australia. This is wonderful news. For one night, and one night only, Billy Joel is heading back down under. Yeah, the Piano Man powerhouse will descend on the MCG for his huge Aussie show on December 10 later this year.
Wow.
Uptown Girl. Tickets go on sale from next week. I don't know the words, but that's the tune, isn't it? Let's get your
I'm
sport.
I'm a rocket man.
Rocket man.
Rocket man. I love that Billy Joel song. Yeah, there you go.
Elton John, guys.
Isn't this his song?
Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
Let me quiet, simple boy.